great evening. I've really enjoyed the choir. It's the enthusiasm of the songs that they're singing. It's what they put into it that really makes it great. When I thought about tonight, I thought about the week we've had. It's been a special week, hasn't it? There's been special things happening. There's been a birth. And all of us, no doubt, have taken note of that, seen in the paper, wanted to know all about it. There's another birth I want to tell you about here. The birth of a young girl called Sophia Charlotte Rose. And she's the great-granddaughter of one of the bandsmen. Now, which one do you think it is? He's got a little bit of one with a big grin on his face. It must be the one in the end. They picked you out, Dave. There you go. Yes, three Christian names, three first names, just like the prince. He's got three, hasn't he? Archie, Harrison, Mountbatten. And they say the Harrison could have come from Harrison. Or whether it's true or not, I don't know. This is what they're saying. And some lucky lady, she picked out his Christian name. Then she got 18,500 when she bet on the Christian name. What a lucky lady she was. Names, I thought. Names are funny things, aren't they? When I was a boy, because my name is Perry, I got called all sorts of things in school. From fish face, when they wanted to be unkind to me, to kipper, when they wanted to be kind. And as I went through life, I became a police officer, and the policeman in the police station used to call me Red. Or a padre, because they knew I went to the Salvation Army. When I meet someone, and I was struggling with them to get them into the cells or the handcuffs, they would call me all sorts of names, like, perhaps I'd better not go there. The names I like to be called, though, are things like son, brother, dad, or granddad. And as I got older, I sort of faded into the background, because now I'm known as Kevin's dad or Joanne's dad, and I'm not really known for myself anymore. No doubt you've had similar experience. We have, as Howard has already told you, a name for our band, and it is quite long. It used to be the over 60s, but because we're so young, we couldn't use that name anymore. When it first started, of course, it was the over 60s. But you have people who are under 60 in the band. Stand up. So we're a fellowship band. I thought about the names that people call us as we are called Salvationists, we're called Christians, and we have many different names. And just like our friends from the hospice here, they have the nurses, they have the staff, and they have the patients. And we try and show to as Salvationists to the world the love of Jesus. And they're showing the love of human kindness to the people who are in the hospice. And we are so grateful for the work that the hospice does, because it will touch each of us, no doubt, in our lives as we go through. Then I thought of the name of God. Now, there was a very funny story I heard the other day about a boy who went to Sunday school, and he rushed home and he said to his mum, "Mum, they taught us the name of God at Sunday school today." So she said, "Did they? What did they teach you?" He said, "Our Father, who art in heaven, Howard be your name." So there you are, Howard, fame at last. We as Christians try to bring some light and love into difficult situations, just like our friends here. And there's a few verses in Isaiah which talk about Jesus and what he did. Now, bear in mind, these verses from Isaiah were written 750 years before he was actually born. The Jews light has shone. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name will be called, here's his name, Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting